I'm Rishti. Now we'll move to the next part of the prokaryotic cell, that is the cytoplasm. As such, since in the prokaryotic cell, all the function of the organelles are performed generally by the plasma membrane, so the cytoplasm does not have most of the complex structures that are present in the eukaryotic cell. But there are still certain things that are present, such as certain kinds of vacuoles are present. Apart from them, we have ribosomes. These vacuoles can also be present in eukaryotic cells, but the function basically differs. So here in case of prokaryotic cells, the vacuoles basically would perform two functions. First is the storage, and second is providing buoyancy to the cell. Buoyancy function would primarily be provided by the air vacuoles that are there, and these occur in only very specific kinds of bacteria that we have. Also, the storage function is for the certain specific kinds of carbohydrates that are there, as well as certain other things. So vacuoles basically do occur as hard solid bodies inside the cell that are appearing. So these are, as when we view through the microscope, so these appear as solid bodies inside the cell, in the inside the cytoplasm, inside the cell. So apart from that, we have ribosomes. So ribosomes are structures which are also there in eukaryotic cell. They differ in two basic things. In eukaryotic cell, the ribosomes are associated with endoplasmic reticulum, whereas in prokaryotic cell, these ribosomes are present randomly inside the cytoplasm. They are not associated with any endoplasmic reticulum since it's not there in the prokaryotic cell itself. Also, the ribosome present here are 70S ribosome. S stands for the Seebeck unit of sedimentation coefficient. So these 70S ribosomes are there. In eukaryotes, you would have ATS ribosomes. So what these 70S ribosome would actually have two units, the smaller and the bigger one, larger unit. The smaller unit here is of 30S and 50S, whereas in case of this, it would be 40S and 60S. So that is how the ribosome basically differ. The function remains the same, protein synthesis, but this is the major target area where antibiotics are actually used. This is because when we give an antibiotic, it should not harm our human body itself. But in case if we target an antibiotic which inhibits the protein synthesis at this step, so it will act only on the 70S ribosome, not on the 80S ribosome. So we can actually discriminate a bacterial cell from our body cell and then kill the bacterial cell, preserving our body cell. So these are the structure. So moving from the cytoplasm, we move to the nuclear region. So since prokaryotes do not have a structured cell kind of a thing, the nuclear material exists as just a looping of a DNA that is called as nucleoid. There are no histone proteins that are present. No histone proteins are associated with this kind of a structure, since otherwise they would have been forming like a chromosome. Only are associated, this is also known as the circular DNA. Apart from the circular DNA that we have in prokaryotes, we also have other nuclear materials such as plasmids, which have varied functions that we would study later during the eventual course of study. Plasmids in general basically provide certain additional functions such as antibiotic resistance, fertility factors and others. The circular DNA is the major DNA that is present in the prokaryotic cell. So hence we complete the prokaryotic cell structure.